Who are you to wave your finger? You must have been out your hair.
Let's wait no longer, shall we? Let's get into the pot by Tool. Here we go.
Who are you to wave your finger? You must have been out your hair. I hold deep in muddy waters. You practically raised the dead. Rob the grave to snow the cradle and burn the evidence down. Soapbox house of cards and glass, so don't go tossing your stones around. You must have been
there's so much to talk about. At the very end, like, that just fucking slapped me around, dude. You got the unbelievably funky bass, okay? You got the drums from a fucking demonic angel, and then you have Maynard, who his vocals are unreal. I don't know if it's Maynard's voice, and I don't think it is just that. I think it's a combination of everything in tandem, but something while you're listening to Tool grabs you, and it just does not let you go. It takes you on the ride, makes you find that pocket, that rhythm, that flow to it that just really gets you into that zone.
I loved that in the end, when he was yelling, elbows deep in muddy waters. That just made me feel, of all the people who have ever judged me or made me feel like I wasn't good enough, or they made me feel like I needed to do more with my life, or I was, you know, wasting my time. And they look down on me when they themselves are guilty of so much as well. Like, they are themselves elbows deep in muddy waters. And then over here, they're casting judgment on me.
Danny Carey. He never disappoints, does he? It's just so good. Such amazing original concept for music and drums. Unbelievable.
The drummer is mental. But that was an amazing song. The singer's voice was good. They've reinvented music. The count was different. The swing, the transitions, everything was just on the Tool level.
That song was incredible.
Oh my god, it's another level. It's so special and different. Wow.
Just the way it sounds. Even just the way it sounds is special. The meaning seems to be along the lines of hypocrisy was in there too.
Cool. I love the intricacy of Tool's music. There's so many specific details that each band member is adding. They're all incredibly technically proficient. Maynard's vocals in particular, I think, are perfectly suited for this band. I love that brewing fury that you can hear in his voice at any given moment. It's great. Loved the extra bit of screams in there we heard as well. I also love the way he's very specific with his diction.
That's it? Nah, that ain't it. Yo, he fucking ran that shit. Yo, shout out to Tool. What the fuck? That shit was different. I don't know why I never listened to Tool before. Like, I really feel like an idiot. Like, this song was fucking amazing, man.
Oh, man. Darn. Whew. It's kind of interesting, right? If you're gonna be this blatant in your language about calling out what I agree with is a hypocritical and unjust law and enforcement. You go in with like all your friends and it's like, you know, we're here and we're not gonna take it anymore. But he starts off by himself. He's alone, he's vulnerable. Hello, my name is Maynard, this is fucked up. And by the end, we're like all with it on the bandwagon and all like together. It's really an effective song, an effective piece of art, an effective piece of social criticism. Really, really awesome.
Hey, the Tool, the pot. What's in the pot? What's cooking in that pot? Because whatever it is, it tastes good. It sounded good.
Oh, was that the end of it, huh? Okay. As I started to listen to it a little bit, you know, I started hearing certain things kind of, you know, hit a little close to home for me. I basically heard in this one that a lot of people want to start spewing, you know, what they think is bad. They want to tell you that what you should do, what you shouldn't be doing. But meanwhile, they're probably into some bullshit themselves, you know, and they don't take responsibility for that, but they want to point the finger at you. Like, don't wave your fingers at me, you know what I mean? And, you know, this message really hit me, you know, but there's also other things that, you know, hit me too. It's more like, if you're not going to be a part of the solution, you know, don't try to think that you're solving a problem by just running your mouth about it, you know?
Wow, within this, what I enjoyed probably the most was the natural sound of the instruments and the natural sound of the lead singer. That was an amazing song right there. You close your eyes and you feel like it just takes you to a different place.
It's hard being a musician because you go through that phase where you feel like you've heard it all. You get real down and low, you know, damn, there's no more music for me to listen to. And then every now and again, you hear something, and you're like, wow, that felt great. And I can't wait to listen to that again. They pulled a switcheroo on us. Because okay. I'm not gonna lie, at the beginning I was like, it's a bit soft.
Yeah, without doubt. And when the guitars came in, like roaring in, it was like, oh, what? It was like it was a teaser, if you get what I'm saying. Let's just tease a little bit. Boom!
I love it. I freaking love it. Wow. I don't know what to say more than that, because the music, it's from a different world.
This is fucking over.
Gave me something where
oh
I was
my
like,
god.
Oh.
This song is fucking over. Are you kidding me? It's outstanding. Everywhere. The rhythm section, the beats, like the...
Everything.
Holy shit.
The lyrics.
Ooh.
Whoa. It completely communicates the message that this is a statement. It's like
and
the
song
is pop.
Fucking ridiculous, man. It really, yeah.
How many licks does it take? It's like, how many misses does it take?
Tootsie Pop! Tootsie Pop, take the lips! So you get to the center, but the center's never there.
It's game over!
Game over, man!